What's up, everyone? Welcome to my channel of Techverse. I'll be showing you how to make a phone bridge inverter circuit with a wattage of 1000 plus. So at the input, you have your battery. It can be a 12 volts, so you can use 2 in series or 4 in series. Then you have the input capacitor. So then the IC, the TL494, is a very reliable passive modulation IC. It's configured to generate 2 push-pull driving signals. So this section here, made up of R6, R7 and C3, consists of the soft start. This allows the output PWM to gradually increase from 0 to about 95% to reduce the stress on the output power MOSFETs when the inverter is powered on. If the frequency is determined by the value of the capacitor C2 and R1, the formula is 50 Hz with the parameters as 10 kilo ohms and 1 microfarad. The formula is shown. You can tweak the parameters to get any frequency from 50 to 60 Hz, or if you want a power inverter, you can tweak it to get 25 kHz or the way to about 300 kHz. So the output transistors would be complementaries of each other, meaning that when the first one is high, the second one is low. So the output signals at the open correctors 1 and 2 will be alternating high and low. With the pull-up resistors, these act as the drivers for the internal full bridge made up of these power BJTs, the BD139 and their complementaries BD140. So when there's a low signal at pin 8, when the output transistor 1 is high, this means that Q3 will be off, but Q5 will be on. And since the signal at the 11 pin or C2 will be high, will be low, I mean, so this means that the transistor, which is Q4, will conduct, and so this will allow current to flow from the 12 volts rail through Q4, through the primary winding of this gate drive transformer, through the current limiting resistor, through Q5 and to ground. This meets the first half cycle. When the signal reverses, that is, the transistor T1 turns on, off, I mean, and the T2 turns on, so there will be a high signal at pin 8, and so Q3 will conduct, as well as Q6. This will allow current to flow from the 12 volts rail through Q3, through the limiting resistor, through the primary of the gate drive transformer, through Q6 and to ground. So the gate drive transformer, usually, there are many tutorials, but the way you do is, like for a full bridge, you grab 5 wires and make about 12 turns. So then note the beginning and ends of each other. The dots indicate the terminals. So with one primary winding, you can generate 4 completely isolated signals to drive each of these single MOSFETs independently. So the drain time opened by the TL494 ensures that at no time will either any of the vertically aligned MOSFETs will conduct at any time, since it can cause a short circuit and a current shoot through and damage your MOSFETs. So what happens is that this will ensure that only the MOSFETs Q2 and Q7 will be conducting at the same time, and Q1 and Q8 will be conducting at the same time. So this will cause a complete full H-bridge signal to be applied on the primary of the transformer, and this will be swinging back and forth at 50 Hz. And so with the primary, then with the appropriate turns on the secondary, you can obtain about 240 volts AC. You can even get 120 volts AC depending on the parameters of the transformer. So the transformer, you should use one of the ratio that will give you the desired output voltage. For 120, you need a transformation ratio of 1:10. Like, you can have about 20 turns on the primary side and 200 turns on the secondary. If you want 240, you need double the winding on the secondary side. So the PCB looks as shown, and this is the final build of the board. So here you have your input battery capacitor, the IC, and its mandatory biasing circuit. So here you have your gate drive H-bridge made up of these power BJTs, and these are the H-bridge output MOSFETs. So these two connections go to the primary of the transformer. So basically, that's all about this inverter. Don't forget to like this video, comment if you have any questions or suggestions, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notifications bell to get immediate updates when I upload new videos. Have a nice time.